We have one more Swede up. He probably has the most extreme story of all of us. He's gone from four guys in a sweaty room to 750 people and a huge company in only a couple of years. So welcome, Niklas from Klarna.
Thank you very much, and thank you for the great conference. Very exciting to be here. My name is Niklas Adalbert. I'm one of the co-founders of Klarna, one of three co-founders. And just to give a short background of what Klarna does, it's not that easy to understand. So imagine yourself if you go to go shop for a shirt. You go into Dressmann, you walk around in aisles, and you're after this perfect shirt. And finally you find it, you see if the quality is correct, you see the color, if that matches what you want. And when you are satisfied with it, you just grab it, take it on to the cashier, swipe your card, and it's done. It's completely safe, because you have the stuff with you all the time. It's quite fast, and it's easy. Doing the same thing online is a total different experience. First of all, you have to fill in all these different fields, and also might have to have a DigiPass for the credit card. And in the end, you're not 100% sure that you will receive the stuff, or if it will just be a stone or something. The way you want to pay is the same thing as you did offline. You want to have the stuff first, and then transfer the money. And this is what Klarna does. So if you go online with a merchant connected to Klarna, or a partner, as Ticktail, connected to Klarna, you just enter the top of mind information, name, address, date of birth, you press buy, and then you get home the stuff together with an invoice, and you just pay it whenever you're satisfied. And this is what Klarna does. So we're somewhere in between, taking this risk. And doing this business, we've been extremely lucky. And what I want to do here now on stage is to, so you don't have to base your startups on pure luck, maybe to share some learnings during this journey. And the first one, I think, is to set the ambition level of the company. It is one thing to start a gas station, and it's another thing to start Statoil. And I think it's very important that the founders agree on this before, because I think that this is otherwise one of the main reasons why the founders can't agree, because they have different ambition level. And our ambition level was to start something cool and something big from start. And doing this with vast experience from Burger King, working at Lekten, at Aker Brygge, and being 23 years old, and as you heard, not really that relevant experience, no money and absolutely no tech knowledge. And we were supposed to build basically a bank. That was quite difficult. So we realized that if we're going to do this idea, we need to be quite generous with the shares. And when we finally found an investor, we gave away 10%. And we also gave away another 37% to the ones building the platform. That was quite tough to start a business and give away basically half the company. But I think that we wouldn't be in where we are today if we hadn't done that. Another thing that I think is important is focus. When we started the company, we tried to also finalize our studies at the Stockholm School of Economics. And of course, this didn't work out at all. So I think it's fine to do multiple things in the beginning, but when you have decided that you're really going to go for the startup, I think it really requires focus and full attention. You can't do multiple things. Another topic that I think is important, and this is going to sound quite boring, is discipline. When we started, once again, every time I looked at Sebastian's screen, my co-founder, he was watching Star Trek. Victor, he was reading business news. And they thought I was reading TechCrunch the entire time and not doing work. So not much things happened in the beginning, and that really killed the motivation. So what we ended up doing was actually to put the screens so they all faced outward, so you could always see what the other one was doing. And that really helped the self-discipline. And we have this still today in the company. All the screens are facing outward, just to help out. Another thing we did was that all the fights we figured out was maybe 90% was regarding who worked most. It's just exactly when you, if you have a fiancé or something, that you always think that you do the most dishes and so on, because you tend to remember when you do it, but not when your partner do it. It's the same with building a business. You only think when yourself are there, and not when the other ones are. So what we ended up doing after hundreds of fights, we actually started to count hours. And that solved it. So 90% of the fights were gone. And I think that was quite good. Another thing, together with the focus and the discipline, is that what we did was to work like crazy. So the first 2 years, we had 5 days vacation in total, weekends included. I think a reason for this was, of course, that with the experience from Burger King, you couldn't add anything really, so you had to be there all the time and do all the mistakes. You're probably much more experienced doing your startup, so maybe you don't have to put in the same amount of hours. And finally, what I'd like to share that I find is very, very important is recruitment. To always focus on recruitment and spend a lot of time on getting the right people in. We would never have achieved what we've done if we wouldn't have brought in much clever and greater experienced people than ourselves. So we three founders have not built this company, it's everyone else that have built this company. And we try to push every manager, everyone in Klarna, to spend at least 25-30% of their time doing recruitment to get the best one in. That makes an entire difference. So with that said, thank you very much, and good luck.